In this video, we're going to talk about retirement and how you can tell it's time to retire. So hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell so you stay educated on how your money works. Deciding when to retire is one of the most difficult career decisions a worker can make. Employees are often earning their maximum income at the point of retirement, so the financial implications of retiring too early can be profound. Careful planning about the transition from full-time employment to retirement can enhance your chances of making a smooth adjustment. There are many elements to consider before making a final decision. Before you decide to retire, consider your job satisfaction, your physical and mental ability to work, your financial stability, your healthcare coverage, and your life satisfaction. So first, let's talk about job satisfaction. Don't confuse an unsatisfying job situation with imperative to retire. Employees who are working a job that is not a good match for their skills, values, and interests are more likely to rush into retirement. Retiring too early can have serious financial consequences, especially if you are not yet eligible for Medicare or Social Security. If you are younger than you expected to be at retirement age, ask yourself these three things. 1. Are you ready to stop working entirely or ready to stop your current job? 2. Would you like to retire if you were in a better work environment? And 3. Would you be happier with a career change rather than retirement? If you have any doubts, consider working with a career counselor or exploring other job opportunities in your field. You may find that a career change is a better choice for you than retiring. You may also discover that your lack of satisfaction with working has nothing to do with the job itself and more to do with your readiness to stop working entirely. If that's the case, it may be time to start considering retirement. Next, let's talk about your physical and mental ability to work. Some physically demanding jobs, such as working in construction, are difficult to continue past a certain age. Even if you prefer to keep working, you may find yourself running into physical difficulties performing your job. If you experience cognitive difficulties or in such health problems run in your family, you may also find yourself considering retirement earlier than you might otherwise want to. If you are concerned about your physical or mental ability to perform your job, talk to your doctor about your concerns. This may be able to give you a projected timeline about how much longer you can expect to keep working. If you anticipate that you have to retire early due to your health or physical ability, start planning early for how you will handle your finances and healthcare during retirement. So then let's talk about financial stability. Once you're retired, you're likely to want to stay retired. That means you want to have enough money saved up to meet your needs. Track your expenses so that you have a realistic handle on how much income you will need to sustain your preferred lifestyle. Some good benchmarks to consider is 1. Save at least 8 times your salary by age 60. Or 2, save at least 10 times your salary by age 67. If your savings are in that ballpark, you could be in a good financial shape to retire. In addition to tracking your current expenses, you'll need to factor in changes that you could reasonably anticipate after retirement. For example, you would no longer be spending on work clothes or commuting costs, but you might spend more on travel, entertainment, dining out, hobbies, and healthcare. Consult a financial planner for insight into whether you have the money you'll need to retire. The Social Security Administration can also help you estimate your retirement benefits. Reach out to a rep from your pension or 401k plans to identify your income potential for those sources. And then there's healthcare coverage. No matter how healthy you are when you stop working, at some point in your retirement, your healthcare needs will increase. Planning for your healthcare costs is a key aspect of planning for retirement. For many retirees, healthcare costs account for the greatest portion of your budget. The average couple who are now 65 will need $295,000 to cover medical costs in retirement, and that doesn't include long-term care. If you aren't yet old enough for Medicare, consider your options for health insurance coverage and know the costs. Meet with a member of HR of your current employer so that you are fully aware of any post-retirement health benefits offered. Even once you're eligible for Medicare, it may not cover all your medical expenses after you retire. About 15% of the average retiree's annual expenses will be related to healthcare. Be sure you have a plan for covering health insurance premiums, regular preventative care, prescription drugs, surgery and other procedures, and long-term care or nursing help. So that then leaves to life satisfaction. In addition to the logistical aspects of retirement, you also need to consider the emotional and personal fallout. While many retirees enjoy the freedom to travel, visit family, and explore hobbies after they leave the workforce, others experience a lack of direction, boredom, and loss of life satisfaction. If you want to make sure you're prepared for retirement, consider doing a trial run while taking some time off from work. You can explore some of your planned pursuits or hobbies, you can do some consulting as a side gig, or you can volunteer with an organization you care about. Many retirees also start with a soft retirement, in which they scale back from full-time work but don't leave the workforce entirely. If you need to generate some income or would prefer to continue with some employment to keep busy, talk to your boss about reducing your hours at work. Scaling back from work a handful of hours at a time provides a way to ease into retirement without any sudden changes to your lifestyle or budget. Your employer might also consider retaining you in another role, such as a consultant. So what are your thoughts? Are you planning to retirement? Are you in the process of retirement? Or are you retired and need something to do? Leave a comment down below and let's get a discussion started. And as always, take care of your money. Today's book of the day is Your Money or Your Life by Vicki Robin. I'll leave a link to the book down below, and if you prefer listening to it on an audiobook for free, I'll also leave a link to a 30-day free trial to Audible. You can choose this book or any book to listen to, and even if you cancel before your free trial is over, you can still keep the book and listen to it whenever you want. Last thing before you go, a financial education is the most important kind of education you can give your kids. That's why I created Smart Money Parenting as a way to prepare you and your kids about the highs and lows of managing your own money. I'll leave a link to the course down below so you can check it out.